James Villegas, the new research and extension field crops entomologist here at the LSU Ag Center. I'm domiciled here at the Deanley Research and Extension Center, and I cover several field crops, including soybean, cotton, sorghum, corn, wheat, and pasture. So today is July 28, 2022, and as we are approaching late into the summer, I'm gonna talk about late season defoliators of soybean. So this is quite timely because a couple of days ago, I just got a call about thresholds and application timing for corn earworms and soybean loopers in soybean plants. So around this time of the year, most of the soybean in the States are around R3 to R6 developmental stages. Thus, it is very important that we are on the lookout for Lepidopteran defoliators, including the soybean loopers, velvet bean caterpillars, the green clover worms, sporadically the fall armyworms, and also the corn earworms. So right behind me is a small field plot trials, and we're gonna go in and scout for some insects that are there in the field. Here we are, we're about to sample this field. So we typically use a sweep net. So this is a very important tool in sampling for insects in your field. This has around 15 inch in diameter and it has a cloth net. So when you scout for insects in soybean fields, particularly in commercial fields, what you would want to do is to scout from several locations, from edges and to the center. All right, so I did around 25 sweeps in one of those small plots, and let's take a look at what we collected here. So I'm seeing, first off, we got a few soybean loopers, more than an inch long, so probably around 4 instar, 15 stars. And I'm also seeing a good number of velvet bean caterpillars here. And I got one corn earworm and a couple of green clover worms. Soybean loopers can build their population in a short amount of time, and it can be exaggerated by the use of broad spectrum insecticides for three-cornered alfalfa hoppers and stink bugs. So soybean loopers would initially feed at the bottom portion of the canopy and move up. So this behavior allowed them to be protected from predators and also from insecticide applications if the canopy is quite dense. Thus, it is important that we do apply insecticides with good coverage. So in Louisiana, the threshold for soybean loopers is 8 half-inch worms per row foot or 150 worms in 100 sweeps. And the insecticides that we use for soybean loopers are Prevothon or Vantacor, Besiege, Intrepid Edge, and Stuart. When the soybean plants reach around R6.5, controlling for soybean loopers is not that much critical. Just a caution that there were reports of looper resistance against the insecticides I mentioned earlier. Velvet bean caterpillars and green clover worms like soybean looper could build population pretty quickly and could defoliate soybean plants in a short amount of time. The threshold for Louisiana is 8 worms or half-inch worms per row foot or 300 worms in 100 sweep. Unlike soybean loopers though, velvet bean caterpillars and the green clover worms can be easily controlled using pyrethroids. So typically what you apply for your stink bugs will be very effective for both of these insect pests. Although not a defoliator, corn earworm could damage soybean plants by feeding on the fruiting structures. So the threshold for Louisiana is 3 half-inch worm per square row foot or 38 worms per 100 sweep. So here in the state, there is a high resistance of corn earworm to pyrethroids. So we don't recommend that you control corn earworms with pyrethroid alone. So some of the insecticides that we use for corn earworms include Vantacor or Prevothon, Besiege, Intrepid Edge, and an acephate plus a pyrethroid. So if you want to know a lot more options in controlling these lepidopteran pests, you could check the 2022 Louisiana Insect Pest Management Guide. So this guide is updated annually by our LSU Ag Center entomologists. The best way to find the guide is to search Louisiana Crops blog, and you can find it under the management guide section, including the weeds and disease management. Lastly, before you make any decision in applying any insecticides, make sure you know what species are available or are present in the field, how many of those are in the field, and what is the defoliation percentage. Post-bloom soybeans can tolerate around 20% defoliation without any consequences. If you have any questions, you could contact me anytime, call, text, or email, and you could also contact your extension agents. We also have a remind group for each of the crops where we send a lot of announcements and some updates on any aspects of crop production in each of those crops. So you will see my contact information and some of the information how to join the remind on the description of this video. Thank you very much and have a great day.